Okay, it's time for the alignment. We're going to turn it on and I'll show you what it does. I brought the cameras in so you can see a little bit closer. We've got the controller. Now, first thing we do is obviously make sure that there's power and you turn it on. And the handbox is saying it's verifying packages and to wait. Ah, now it says CPC ready and to begin the alignment, let's press enter. So, and it's going to ask me what sort of alignment it's going to be. Now, it's during the day and we're inside, so clearly a sky alignment is not going to happen. What I do know is that you can do a daytime single star alignment if you know where one of the stars are. So this is going to be a bit of a simulation, but there you go. So what I'll do is I'll just select one star alignment. There, I don't know if you can see that. It says select method of one star alignment. So press enter. And it's going to ask me what time it is. That's about right, actually. Yeah, it's 11:43, so... Oops. 11:43, and enter. Yes, it is AM. Yes, it is daylight saving. It is March the 2nd, 2019. And now it's going to ask me what star I want to align on. Now, I happen to know that phone will help is around, and I think I know where it is too. So what I'll do... scroll through the finder, phone, there it is. So press enter, and now what we do is we find that we point the tube roughly at Fomalhaut. Now if it's night time, what you would do is you put your eye to the finder scope to There's two phases to this. There's a coarse phase and a fine phase. At the moment, the first thing it does is it's in its coarse phase, which means that the motors will slew quickly. Now, I know that Fomalhaut is sort of about there, so I'll just... around we go, and up a bit. That's about east, and it needs to be about a little bit more than 45 degrees, so it's sort of like... Okay, now what we do is we say, we press enter to finish the coarse phase, which we were actually supposed to be looking for. We're supposed to have found it in the finder scope, which we will have already aligned, obviously. So press enter, let's imagine we found it in there. And now it says align Fomalhaut, and you use the buttons again, only it will be a lot slower to get it. And what we do is we find Fomalhaut in the middle of this lens here, the actual eyepiece. So let's imagine we're in here, we go la 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 la, and the microphone probably can't pick it up, but when I press these buttons, it is slewing very slowly. So let's imagine we found Fomalhaut in there, and you press the align button, and then it says align successful. And now it says CPC ready. So what now is, basically it's asking you what you want, what does it want to show you, or what do you want it to show you. So let's imagine, what's up during the day at the moment? Saturn. Saturn is around, so what we do is we press solar system, and then we scroll up or down to, this is Mercury, Venus, Mars, Pluto, Neptune, Uranus, Saturn. There we go, Saturn. Press enter. And it finds Saturn. Isn't that magic? Now, it's already done a one-star alignment. That is not always all that accurate. I would recommend that you do a proper sky alignment when you actually see stars. It takes about a few extra minutes, but it's well worth it, and it will mean that the slews are very much more accurate. Anyway, Saturn is, I'm just going to have to believe it, is up there, and if we look in there, we should be able to see it all very close. So just pop that back in there, and I think we're done. Okay, now the last thing I needed to talk about is what does and doesn't come with the scope. Generally speaking, it's the options that you're after. Cabling is, or should I say electricity, is something you're going to have to think about. It comes with a cigarette lighter attachment, which is long enough to go to your car. The great thing about this is that the cigarette lighter attachment comes with a little collar on it, which means that it won't fall out, which is, has happened to me before. If you're working near a house or you've got electricity in, say, a pillar or something like that nearby, you can get yourself a power adapter, which just goes straight to a from a wall socket straight to this using a transformer. That puts the right amount of volts in. It's just 12 volts it needs. Or you can get this. This is a Celestron power tank, which that's believes it, well, it comes in a number of different capacities. This one might be 7 amp hours. This will keep you going pretty much all night, as long as you're not slowing left and right all over the place. You can also get a StarSense aligner for the CPC. The StarSense aligner will mean that you don't need to do, well, you still need to go through the star alignment procedures. You don't need to look through any of this stuff. The StarSense will just look for you, and it finds the stars and centers them automatically, and so all you have to do is stand back and watch it align itself, and then you are, and then it asks you what you want to look. The other thing that you can get with this is the wedge. The wedge is an angled bracket which sits underneath the mount and on top of the tripod here. It rocks the whole thing back onto the relevant angle for your latitude, turning it into an equatorial mount. For long period astrophotography, you probably want to have, besides that, you probably want the auto guider as well. The auto guider just goes onto a second telescope arrangement sitting at the top there, and that will mean that it tracks that much better for your astrophotography. If you're a dedicated astrophotographer, you might consider getting the equatorial mount though for this. It is available with an equatorial mount. You can get a CGX or a CGXL for this, or for this type of tube. You've got to think about what your own needs might be when you're deciding what telescope to use. The having a wedge and the auto guider does give you a good solution, but it's probably the second best solution, speaking as the astrophotographer myself. I think that's really all I need to talk about with this telescope. Just to wrap up, it is big. It is a very large telescope. It's not light. It's on the border of being portable. It is portable, but yeah, don't drop it. Have a good time.